Very good morning to all of you. Welcome to yet another initiative by Magarpatta Group for a three series webinar on wildlife and habitats around Pune and forests of Central Maharashtra. Today is the second webinar of the series that will cover the wetlands and grasslands around Pune by Vinod Bartakke. Mr. Satish Magar has a few words that he would like to share with us before we begin the webinar.
Friends, we all have made this historical and multicultural city our home. We all know our city's strengths, which are in education, industry, agriculture and IT. But when it comes to wildlife, we can only think of Ranthambore National Park or Bandipur, but not visualize wildlife in highly urbanized Pune or the state of Maharashtra. Magarpatta City Group, under its new initiative of Know Your City, has now collaborated with the organization called Jungle Bells to conduct a series of webinars on the wildlife of Maharashtra. The first webinar on the wildlife around Pune is being presented to you today, which will be followed by wetlands and greenlands around Pune and finally forests of Central Maharashtra. We are also in the process of making a short film on the wildlife around Pune. We hope you will like our initiative and encourage our team to give more to you in future. Thank you and have a good day.
Thank you, sir, for the message. As Mr. Magar mentioned in his message, Magarpatta Group, in association with Jungle Bells, Nature Walk Outdoors, Sanjay Deshpande, and Vinod Bartakke, has taken an initiative to make a film on wildlife treasures around Pune. Here's a teaser of this film for all of you. Over to you, Arvind. Now, let's move on to the webinar. My colleague Aarti will introduce our speaker for today, Mr. Vinod Bartakke.
Hello and good morning to all of you. Let's hear a little bit about our speaker for today. Vinod Bartakke is a full-time wildlife photographer and an independent filmmaker. He finds happiness roaming in the wilderness. He has traveled to wildlife sanctuaries and national parks across the country to observe and photograph the denizens of the Indian jungles. In his free time, he makes sure to visit wildlife hotspots in and around Pune. He posts as @VinodBartakke on Instagram. Finalist for the NHM Wildlife Photographer of the Year 2010 and 2015. Special mention at the Burar Lucas Wild Photo 2016 Photo Contest. He's conducted multiple photography workshops and judged quite a few photography competitions. He started wildlife photography in 2004. Driven by the passion for wildlife photography, he has traveled to various sanctuaries and national parks across India and abroad. He visits Spiti Valley in Himachal Pradesh every year in search of the elusive snow leopard. He has made a short film on Kidwar Wildlife Sanctuary, Himachal Pradesh, showcasing the rare animals of this remote high altitude sanctuary. He's a postgraduate in electronics with various IT certifications. Besides traveling and wildlife photography, he also likes playing chess. And he has also done a wildlife documentary called Secrets of Wild Pune. Welcome to the webinar, Vinod. Just a couple of things. There will be two short quizzes that Vinod is going to conduct on wildlife during the webinar. So everybody, please be alert. And you can type your answers. Those who are watching on Zoom, you can type your answers in the chat box. And those who are watching on Facebook can put in your answers on the comments, in the comments section. And we will, announce the people who have given us right answers. And, you know, don't worry about the answer being right or wrong. Take a guess if you want to, and please do participate. Also, if there are any questions for the speaker, please do type them in the chat box again for Zoom and in the comments section of Facebook. And we will take them up later at the end of the webinar. Over to you, Vinod.
Hi, everyone. Good morning. I hope you can see my video and hear me out clearly.
Yes.
Can you come up? Yeah. Good. So, good morning, everyone. I'm Vinod Paratakke, and I welcome you to this session on grasslands and wetlands around Pune, arranged by Jungle Dales and Mugatpatta Group. So, in this presentation, I will be showing you different birds, mammals, basically the fauna of Pune and surrounding areas, and how lucky we are because we stay in Pune, because Pune is surrounded by various diverse habitats, and these diverse habitats support a multitude of wide array of wildlife, birds, insects, mammals. I'll share my screen, and if you can just confirm, I'll share the screen. Can you confirm if?
Yeah, it's visible. You can just go into the slideshow mode and then.
Great. Okay.
Yeah. Perfect.
Right. So this is the today's topic, as I said earlier, is grasslands and wetlands of Pune. So before we actually go, I have very few slides actually, maybe two or three slides, but I'll be trying to explain this topic with the help of photo maps that I have clicked over past 7-8 years. And these photographs will be mostly from grassland areas and grassland, scrubland, also called as scrubland, and the wetlands around Pune. So all these photos are clicked in and around Pune at these different habitats. Okay, so this is the agenda. I'll briefly try to cover the species diversity and habitats in and around Pune, grasslands of Pune, and there will be a photo slideshow followed by question and answers. So let's move on to the next slide. So, we all know there are different types of habitats. We just say it's a jungle. We see all the beautiful birds, mammals, in different national parks and sanctuaries, and we call that habitat a jungle or forest. So here in this slide, the symbol for forest is F, just the short form. But besides forest, there are various other habitat types, like scrubland, also denoted by letter S here in this slide, grassland, which is the topic, today's topic, main topic, water bodies or wetlands, which is we will cover what are the different water bodies in and around Pune. Plantations and gardens also, they form a major wildlife habitat, because a lot of birds are seen in the gardens around inside the city. Plantations and agriculture, like, you know, sugarcane farm, it is a very good habitat. The leopards of Pune rural areas have adapted to this habitat type. So these are the various habitat types, and you just see how many different types of birds and mammals, as per this slide, they have adopted these habitat types. This is just to give you, and this is for Pune. This is for Pune region. I'm not talking about Maharashtra or India. This is for our own Pune. And when I say Pune, it's Pune and maybe approximately 60 to 80 kilometers from the city, circle around, consider the circle around the city. So, which includes areas like Saswad and Jejuri, Murgaon on one side. On the other side, it is like Tamini, Mulshi area. Then, Divighat, Bhutevghat. On one side, it is Lonawala towards, while moving towards Mumbai. So, all these areas we consider as, various different habitats around Pune. So, this slide will just give you an idea, what is the diversity of different birds and animals found in and around Pune. So, this is, this second slide gives you the exact count. This was a study performed by a couple of research institutes in Pune. This is a bit old study, actually. This is 3-4 years back. But I have included this in the presentation, because it will give you an idea. Aquatic insects. You see, aquatic insects, there are 13 different aquatic insects. Snails, there are 15 different snails found in it. They have been recorded in and around Pune. Ants, butterflies, fishes, amphibians, reptiles, and today's main topic, which I have highlighted, birds and mammals. Because, these are the star species. People usually tend to neglect the lower, lesser fauna or, lesser things like ants, fishes, amphibians. People usually, because they are not very colorful, they are, but sometimes, these birds and these birds and mammals are more attractive. So this is, I'm talking about the majority of people. So just see, 332 different types of birds have been recorded in and around Pune, and 65 different types of mammals have been recorded. Though this is old data, you see the numbers, 300 plus still, 300 plus birds and almost 50-55 plus mammals are still found in and around Pune. So that's the diversity which we have, and we are really blessed. Okay. So now coming back to, before I go to the next slide, which is the last slide, by the way, and then I'll showcase what all birds and what all mammals are seen in and around Pune. So what is grassland? Today we will be covering the fauna of grassland and wetland. But what is grassland? I'll just briefly give you a very simple definition of grasslands. Grassland is a habitat, some ecosystem where the dominant species is grass. Very simple definition. So a landscape which is dominated by grass, it also has trees, depending on the geographical location, and different types of grasslands are there. We won't go into the technical details, but basically a landscape which is dominated by grass and shrubs. Okay, and what is the importance? Like, if you compare this habitat, grassland is a habitat, one type of habitat. We have seen many other, like wetlands, forest, scrub, agriculture, plantation, etc. So grassland has its own importance, because there are certain species which are found, certain species of birds, certain species of insects, mammals, only in grassland habitat. And it has its own economical, ecological, and social importance, this particular habitat type. So when we think of animals, say birds or mammals, for example, we only think of national parks and sanctuaries. And India has various different national parks and sanctuaries. We are really blessed. But vast extent of India's biodiversity lives outside these protected areas. So they are not found in national parks and sanctuaries, but other habitats like agriculture, plantation, garden, wetlands, scrubland, grassland. So grasslands cover about 16% of India's geographical area, while wetlands cover almost 5%. So it is a huge number if you compare with the protected area. Protected area might be less than this total number. So these grasslands, when I say grasslands, they are just grasslands? No, they are seasonal. I mean, some grasslands can turn into wetlands after monsoons because of the water logging. And therefore, they provide habitats for a wide variety of flora, which is plants, flowering plants, and fauna, which is animals, insects, mammals, during these phases, both phases, that is grasslands, and when they turn into wetlands. So that's what I wanted to cover. And what is the specialty of grassland? Because, today I will show you some photos of a very special mammal, which is called Indian grey wolf or Indian wolf. And in Marathi, we call it Landga. So, Indian wolf is a grassland species which is rarely found in the jungles. Yes, there are some records in jungles like Taroba, Bench, etc. But hardly, it's very rare. Whereas, if you go to grassland habitats like Saswad, areas like Saswad, which is very close from Magarpatta city. I mean, just travel 20-30 kilometers from Magarpatta in the direction of Dive Ghat, Obdev Ghat, then you go to Jejuri, Morgaon or Saswad area. There are areas where we get wolf packs. Wolf lives in packs, in groups, then they are called packs. So these wolves have beautifully adapted to grassland or scrubland habitats. And that's the reason they have survived so long. They have survived so long adjacent to the human habitation. Wolf is an endangered species, and it is protected under Wildlife Protection Act. So now let's go to the last slide of this. I mean, after this, there won't be any PowerPoint presentation, but I will show you the photographs. So you see what are different wildlife hotspots around Pune and what type of habitat they represent. Most of you, I'm sure, are familiar with at least some of these locations which I have mentioned, like Sihargarh Fort and the base of the Sihargarh Fort, we call it Valley. Then there is a ghat called as Pabe Ghat, just on the back side of the Sihargarh Fort. Rajmachi, again a fort. These are beautiful forest-type habitats. Then areas like Murshi, Tamini, Dongarwadi, again a good forest habitat. Bhima Shankar is a wildlife sanctuary in Maharashtra, about 60-80 kilometers from Pune. Vedanta Tekdi, Araya Hills, Mahatma Tekdi, these are all the small hills right in the heart of the city. Parvati, Talzai Hills, these are all, these are forest types, they are plantations, some scrubland. Then there are water bodies around Pune, in and around Pune, like Veer Dam, Pashande, Mulamutha River, Bigwan. Bigwan is a very well-known wetland, and it is on Pune Solapur Road. Hardly 1.5 to 2 hours from Magarpatta city. Murshi Dam, Lonavala Dam, again a wetland. Dive Ghat, Bogdev Ghat, Saswad, Jejuri, all these are grassland. So we will be concentrating all these areas. I'll try to show the photos which I have personally taken from these locations. So. Right, so what I'll do, I'll just switch the screen and I'll try to show you some photos of grassland. Can you see this image? Can you see this photo? This is a typical grassland habitat. And I'll try to zoom in a bit. This was a photo taken 2 years back, and this was at a place called Garbanwadi, which is near Bigwan on Pune Solapur Road. And you see, I'll just try to zoom. There is a wolf, Indian wolf, resting. it was sleeping there. So I hope you can see this. So this is a representative grassland habitat, typical grassland habitat. This is again a grassland habitat just after monsoons, and if you see a small there, and you know, you also see some vegetation, some grass, but like Feb, March, May, April, May, this area becomes totally barren. It becomes totally barren. Same, similar, you know, habitat. You see, vast areas, water bodies. So this is just to give you an idea of what a typical grassland habitat, scrubland habitat looks like. So now I will show you some photos of birds, which will give you an idea of what kind of birds are seen. Okay, I hope you can see this image. So I'm sure everyone knows this bird. This is, we commonly call it as peacock, but the technical or the common English name of this bird is Indian peafowl. The next one is Aciprinia. So here, you know, the purpose is I will try to show you as many photographs as possible just to give you an idea of the diversity of birds which are seen in these habitats. So Aciprinia is a very small bird, very small, you know, the size is smaller than that of a sparrow, slightly smaller than sparrow. This is a bird looks similar to sparrow, but this is a singing lark, singing bush lark, again found in grassland area. This is a very beautiful bird called as Indian roller. We see it very commonly in Saswad area, and in Marathi it is called Nilpankh. Pankh jache dhale asta. So in Marathi it's also called Nilpankh, Indian roller. And this is a resident bird. Whole year you will, entire year you can see this bird in and around. And this is a different bird, the second bird, which is called as European roller. So it migrates from Europe during winter seasons because of extreme cold to India, and it is seen in the in our grassland habitat in Saswad area, Saswad, Udavji, sorry, any grassland habitat around. So you see the difference between the colors. Indian roller is very dark in color. This is, the color is white, but it's a migratory bird. Again, this is again a local migratory bird, a very beautiful bird. This is called Jacobin's cuckoo. It is cuckoo, belongs to cuckoo family, and the old name is pied crested cuckoo. Marathi name of this bird is Chatak. Chatak, Marathi Chatak Manta. Usually, you know, when you see this bird, it seems, people think like, you know, now the rainy season will start. Another grassland or scrubland type bird, habitat bird, is Sirkir Malkoha. Sirkir, S-I-R-K-E-K-E-R or K-I-R, Sirkir Malkoha. The peculiar characteristic is it's colorful, big. Bit rare bird, you don't see very often these Malkohas, but only seen in that kind of Saswad type habitat. This is again a different type of lark, Sykes lark. You see the crest, again the same sparrow size bird. This one is a very common bird, a wire-tailed swallow, found in various different habitats. And they're very, hardly you will see them sitting. Most of the time they sit on these electric wires on the side of the highway. But most of the time they just keep on flying. Rarely they sit. Another type of bird is, this is a pented francolin. And very beautiful design on this bird. And during breeding season, they are very active. So, same bird, different image. And it's, you know, breeding season is, it becomes very active, very vocal. It is calling. It is trying to attract female. Because it's breeding season. And during breeding season, most of these birds and mammals they get colorful plumage and they look very beautiful, especially the males. In birds, the males are very, very beautiful as compared to females. This is again a different bird, painted sand grouse. We also see chestnut-bellied sand grouse, which is very, very common bird from our grasslands. But this particular is very rare, not very common, and very, very beautiful bird, painted sand grouse. Here you see the pair, male and female. And I'm sure you must have guessed which one is the male and which one is female. The bird on your right hand side, which looks more attractive, I'll just try to zoom in a bit. The bird on your right is the male, and on the left hand side is the female. Here you see the entire family. These are juveniles, these are not the adult birds. These are adult birds, the previous slide, and the next slide you can see these are juveniles, young ones of same painted sand grouse. This is again a very beautiful bird. This is called bayback shrike. We see different type of shrikes. We see different type of shrikes in our habitats. The most common is long tail shrike. This one is bayback shrike. Very beautiful. Very difficult to photograph because it doesn't sit still. And the third, third type is southern grey shrike. This is southern grey shrike, which is a local migratory bird, a different birds. And basically, most of these birds eat small insects. This is again a typical bird of grassland or shrubland habitat. This is yellow wattled lapwing. What is wattle? Wattle is a loose skin around the beak. You can see it very clearly, that loose skin around between eye and the base of the beak. That is called as a wattle. The other lapwing which we see in our city areas is red wattle lapwing. So that this loose skin or wattle is red colored, and it is a very common bird. In Marathi, we call it titwi. Whereas this yellow wattle is maltitwi in Marathi. Not commonly found. This is a babbler or jungle babbler, found in various different habitats, and usually they are in a group. In Marathi we call it sadhle. They make loud noise, very harsh noise when they are together. This is again an indicator species of grassland. This is young one or juvenile of Indian courser. Indian courser, dhavik, mantak Marathi madhe dhavik. So, they usually run on the ground. That's why it's called dhavik, runner bird. And very beautiful bird, Indian courser. This one is a star species. Unfortunately, this has now become extinct from our area. These birds, great Indian bustard, in Marathi, maldhok. There is an entire sanctuary declared for this bird in Nanas. Nanas is a Maldok sanctuary or Great Indian Bustard Sanctuary. Unfortunately, this bird is now extinct. Very beautiful, big size bird. It is, if you just to compare, bigger than an eagle. I will show you some eagle photos afterwards. It's bigger in size than eagle. Very tall bird, tall, handsome bird. Again, a different photo of this great Indian bustard. And they are indicator species of grassland habitat. They are not found in jungles. This is again a bird, very beautiful bird with or in Marathi it's called hudhud, Indian hoopoe. This is again very beautiful small bird, belongs to quail family. This is a rain quail. Rain, why rain? Because in rainy seasons it becomes active. Rainy season is the breeding season for this bird. And this is the male of the species, and it becomes very active, very vocal, and it keeps on calling continuously, big, 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 kind of a typical sound, again trying to attract female. The same bird, you can see, it's very beautiful. This is, you know, a dove, different kind of dove, red colored dove. We see, you know, pigeons in and around the city. Sometimes we also see a dove in the city, which is laughing dove or little brown dove. But in the grassland habitat, we see this red collared dove. It has a collar. If you see a black colored collar, it's there around its neck. This is a rock bush quail. The size is similar to our wren quail, which we saw 2 slides back. So this is rock bush quail, again found in grassland habitat. The same bird, you see it standing on the rock. Rock and bushes, it likes rock and bush. That's why maybe rock bush quail, and it's calling. This is the spotted dove, which is again a very, very common bird. Spotted dove, very beautiful, very common. This is a sparrow-sized bird called as striolated bunting. Again, a very beautiful local migratory bird, seen only in certain seasons. Usually November, December is the season to see them if you visit areas near the grasslands near Saswad area. This is thickney. Very typical bird. I mean thickney. Why it is called thickney? Because the joint, the knee joint is very, very thick. And that's why the name. And again, a beautiful bird. Not very common. Commonly seen. Common in the grassland habitat, but not very commonly seen in and around Pune. This is a very beautiful small bird. Parrot. Vernal hanging parrot. This is the only true parrot seen in India, because we see various different type of parrots. In Marathi we call it popat. Marathi madhe popat mhantat. So this is the only true parrot. We call parrots are actually parakeets. You know, we see various different types of parakeets in the city. Rose-headed parakeet, plum-headed parakeet, Alexandrian parakeet. These are the 3 different types seen in and around city. But this is not a city bird. This usually in jungle, forest type habitat, grassland type habitat. And very small in size, very colorful. I hope you can see our hello, Aarti. Because I'm getting a message that internet connection is unstable. Tell Aarti or Mangit to please confirm if you can still see the slides.
We are able to hear you, Vinod, but it is a little patchy. Earlier it was fine, just recently it started getting a little... Are you there?
Slowly, while changing the images.
Okay, you're back now.
Okay.
We couldn't hear you for a while. Maybe in the last 2-3 sentences you can repeat.
Right. So I'll repeat. I said I will go a bit slow while changing the images because I think there are some issues with internet connection.
Okay, sure.
Yeah. So this next slide is a black stork, black colored. You see, very beautiful bird, big in size, bigger than egret or heron. I'll show you some heron photos. So now we are coming to wetland birds. Birds which are found near water bodies. So this is a very beautiful, rare bird. It is a treat to see and photograph a black stork. The next photo is brown crake. Again, you know, you see this typical common bird. But rarely seen. It is common, but no, it keeps, it usually in the utter growth around the water body. So, brown crake, beautiful bird. The next bird is very common. I'm sure all of you must have seen this bird. And this is cattle egret. people also call me Marathi Gai Bagra, cattle egret, and it basically eats insects as seen in this photo. This is again a different type of egret, large egret or great egret, because it is bigger in size and slight color difference in the beak or claw foot as compared to little egret. So this next photo is of a heron. This photo I clicked at Big One. Big One is a water body, wetland. I'm sure some of you are aware. It's hardly 70-80 kilometers from Agarpatta city on Solapur Highway, and very famous for bird watching. And there are a lot of small grassland habitats around Big One. So I'll request you guys, whenever you get some time, entire family can visit these locations to see a wide variety of birds as well as mammals. So this is grey heron, and it has got a fish as seen in the photo. This is there is a different type of family of birds called as ibises. I have identified based on their peculiar beak. You see, this is black headed ibis, called as white ibis, because major part of the body is white, but the beak and head is completely black. The next ibis, as seen in the photo, this is different type of ibis. This is red headed. You see this red patch on top of its head, so that is red headed ibis. And again, the speciality of ibises is their beak, a long curved beak. You see here also and here also. There is one more type. I don't have the photo right now in this presentation. It's glossy ibis. I don't have it here. This is again a very special bird. This is Indian nightjar. There are various types of nightjars found around Pune. This is one of them. And as the name suggests, it is active during night time. No, nocturnal bird. Most of the birds are diurnal, which means they are active during daytime. But there are some birds like nightjar and some owls, or rather most of the owls, which are active during nighttime, and that's why they are nocturnal. So this is again taken at Saswad at around 9 p.m. when 2-3 years back. This is wagtail, pied wagtail. Marathi madhe dhobi manta thala, because it keeps on wagging its tail as if it is washing its clothes. So dhobi, pied is in English, in ornithology, and ornithology is nothing but study of, or science, study of birds. Science of studying birds is ornithology. In ornithology, pied means black and white. So this is black and white, or pied wagtail. Another bird, very beautiful, is purple moorhen. This is a different photo. I mean, this is the flight shot of purple moorhen. And here you see two different purple moorhens fighting for territory, and or maybe to protect the young ones. If you see a small black dot at the base of the image, is nothing but the chick of one of the purple moorhens. So maybe it was trying to, you know, protect the chick from the other purple moorhen, and they were fighting. Different type of water bird. Here you see, in this image, you see three different types of birds. The main bird, this one, is spoonbill. You see the bill, the beak or the bill of this bird in the center. It's like a spoon. In Marathi, it's called thaptya. I mean, you know, chaptya chochicha bagra. Spoonbill. On the left hand side, this bird, which is now in the center of the frame, is open bill stork, which is not very clear, so forget it. And on the extreme right is ibis, this black headed ibis. Okay, so the main bird here, which I wanted to show it to you, is spoonbill. again a different bird, white-breasted water hen. So it is a hen, comedy, type of hen, white-breasted, it is a white breast. Again found beside small water bodies. This is a stork, again a very big bird, and it's called woolly. Woolly is white, the woolly necked. You see the neck of this bird, it's woolly white. So that's why this is woolly necked stork. This is a rare bird found in our scrublands, grasslands. This is called Eurasian wryneck. I don't know the Marathi name, but this is a rare bird, and getting a photo of this bird, it's a bit difficult, not very easy. So again, you know, why I'm showing all these different photos, just to, you know, showcase the variety of birds which are seen in and around Pune. All these photos are clicked in and around Pune. All these birds are seen in and around Pune. So, before I go to the next slide, maybe just to check if I'm not boring you people and you're still interested, you're still awake, I'll ask you two quiz questions. And I request you all to try to give answers. These are very simple questions related to birds. Please answer these questions in your chat box, type box. My colleague Aarti or Himangi will then, you know, just note down the your answers, and maybe we will see how many of you have tried. See, getting right answer is not important. Trying is important. So please try. Very simple question. I'll ask the first question. Do you know which is our national bird? India's national bird. If you know the answer, type it in your chat box. I'll ask second question. So I'm going to ask two questions. Just to check.
Yes, absolutely right. A peacock is right. Vinod, you can also see the answers. I think that was too easy a question.
No, that is because it's just a start.
I'm going
to do a difficult one. Yeah.
A lot of people have gotten it right.
Yes, okay. Now, great, thanks. So, national animal bird. Do you know what is state bird of Maharashtra? If you know the answer.
Maybe a little, yeah.
Yeah, it might be, you know, you need not know it, but if you know it, it's very good. And those who don't know can give it a try, because ultimately we will reveal the answer and you will know which is the state.
Green dove. Hemant Tikekar says green dove. Is that?
Very close. Yeah.
Haryal.
No, actually it's not dove, but he's very close. A good attempt. I'm really happy that he's trying. Yeah.
Sonia Bujbal says pigeon.
Okay, yes, pigeon, but which pigeon? Because there are,
you know,
correct, yeah, pigeon. It is a pigeon, so that's a hint to all of you, because we get, you know, in our society also, we see a lot of pigeons, which are, you know, blue rock pigeon. It's not the state bird. It's a very common, in fact, we call it pest. it's a pest.
Haryal is, I don't think, the right.
Sorry, which one?
Haryal.
Yes, that is the correct answer. That's the Marathi name, Haria, and the English name is yellow-footed green pigeon. So it is green, that's why Haria, Hirua, Hari means, Harial means green-colored bird. So it's a green pigeon, but it is not only green, the feet are yellow, green, yellow-footed green pigeon.
Okay. Sachin Dharne got it right.
Okay, great. Congratulations. Yeah. And now, very simple question. What is the national animal of India? I am sure now at least 90% of you should get it right.
Tiger, Royal Bengal tiger. Yes, absolutely.
Tiger or lion?
Sorry?
I'm just asking, is it tiger or lion?
No, most people here know it. It's the tiger. That's right.
Wonderful. Now, the last question of this session. What is the state animal of Maharashtra? What is the state animal of Maharashtra? It is a bit difficult because...
Wolf is not the... Giant squirrel. That's right. Sonia Bujbal answered it. Giant squirrel, right?
Yes. Perfect. So Indian giant squirrel, or in Marathi it's called Shekru. Is the correct answer. That is the state animal of Maharashtra. I have the photo, but not in this presentation. Maybe those who are interested, I will share it later. I have a lot of photos of Shekru. Okay, so thanks for answering these questions. Let's come back to our presentation. I'll try to cover as many photos as possible, because we have, after the birds session, now there are, this is the last part of the bird session, where I'll be covering various hawks, harriers, and eagles, and a couple of owls. So that will end the bird session, and we will briefly see what different types of mammals are seen. Of course, the number of mammals is very, very less as compared to number of birds. We see 330 plus birds, whereas hardly 30 plus mammals. Actual recorded number is 60-65, but nowadays it has reduced to 30-35, because some of them are extinct here, or they have moved away because of habitat loss, poaching, various reasons. I mean, these two are the main culprits: habitat loss and poaching for extinction of different mammals or insects or butterflies or whatever. Okay, so this image is blackwing kite or black shouldered kite, the new name, and in Marathi it's called Kapshi. It's the size is less than kite, but equal to maybe a crow, for example. Bird of prey. What is bird of prey? It eats smaller insects. It's a carnivorous bird, so it eats smaller lizards, frogs, etc., insects. This is common kestrel. Again, a very beautiful bird of prey. Eats, you know, caterpillars, insects, etc., butterflies. Very beautiful. This is a female of common kestrel. Kestrel is in Marathi it's called kharuchi. And this is the male. You see the difference? Male is beautifully colored, whereas the previous image, this one, this is the female, this is the male of the same species, common kestrel. And these are residents of our area. I mean, entire year you can see them in grassland habitat. Whereas this next photo is again the female of a kestrel, but it is not common. It is lesser, L-E-S-S-E-R, smaller in size. And this is a very rare migratory bird to Pune. So they come, they travel all the way from Europe during winter seasons. And very, very rare to get to see this bird. I have to wait for 3 years. I was visiting different areas. Finally, I saw it near, once in Saswad, but this photo I took near Lonavala Dam. Did it like 3 years back, 4 years back. So this is female of lesser kestrel. Very rare bird, migratory bird. The next one is again a migratory bird. This is called as lagar falcon, L-A-G-G-A-R, lagar or lagar, however you pronounce, lagar falcon. It is a falcon, eats small birds, lizards, etc. And the good thing is, right now, this bird is seen near Biguan area. Every day, people are posting photos on Instagram, on WhatsApp groups, Facebook, etc. So this bird has arrived and is seen regularly nowadays. Very rare to see in Pune. Same species, lagar falcon, taken at different location. Lagar falcon only, same image. Now, this is the male of lesser kestrel. I showed you the female bit. Yeah, this is the female, which I already showed you. Lesser kestrel, and this is the male. See how beautiful this bird looks. Very rare, and it was my dream to get such a photo. I mean, you know, the bird standing with no clean background, no distraction, was a dream for a wildlife photographer like me. And I finally got it at Lonavala. The next bird is Shikra. This is seen even in our societies. If you observe carefully, you will definitely see, because it hunts smaller birds. I showed you images of larks, you know, bush lark, singing lark, etc., Zitting cesticola, or even small sparrows. So this bird specifically kills small birds and eats them, shikra. This is a hawk, slightly larger than shikra, or maybe sometimes similar size. And this is Eurasian sparrowhawk, same bird. This next image is same bird, Eurasian sparrowhawk. You see the typical feature of these hawks and kite, you know, harriers is their beak. You see the curved beak, very, very powerful beak, and these talons. So it is very, very powerful. They are, you know, killing machines. They just grab the smaller birds and kill them. This is same. This photo actually of the same bird, Eurasian sparrowhawk male, but I did not take this photo around Pune. The bird is seen in Pune and around Pune, but this photo was taken at Little Run of Kutch in Gujarat. I included it here because of the Fortuner in the photo, and I want, you know, it has killed a small bird. I am not sure whether you can see it. There is a small bird kill. And you can see the beak. You can see the beak. It was trying to eat that kill. Now the next one, the family of birds is harriers. Two, three years back, Tata Motors have launched this Tata Harrier. So that Harrier name, they took it from this bird, because I have a few friends who are also bird watchers and photographers in Tata, and they are, you know, coming, they are nowadays giving different bird names to their vehicle models. So Tata Harrier is one of them. So this is Montague's Harrier, very beautiful bird of prey. Again, a migratory bird, local migratory bird to Pune. Same bird, Montague's Harrier. This is the female of the same bird. See the color difference. It was the male was, you know, light blue colored, gray, light gray blue colored, whereas this is dark colored, dark brown. Again, the same bird, Montague's Harrier. You know, different portion. This is pallid harrier. Okay, pallid harrier. Most, you know, you see white and light gray, light bluish gray color. Very beautiful bird, pallid harrier. And the female looks exactly like this. In fact, it is very difficult to tell the difference between two females. I mean, if somebody shows you the photo of harrier female, it can be Montague's harrier or pallid harrier. It's very difficult. But males, you can easily identify. This is again, this is pallid harrier female. Now we come to eagles. This is a very, very powerful eagle called as Bonelli's eagle. Bonelli, B-O-N-N-E-L-L-I, apostrophe S, Bonelli's eagle. So very powerful eagle. I'll show you the next photo. Here in this photo, you can see the pair of Bonelli's eagle. And these eagles are so powerful, they hunt birds, smaller birds, as well as smaller mammals. Like, they can hunt a fox, they can hunt hare, they can hunt, you know, puppies of wolf, puppies of jackal. They are very powerful, very, very powerful. And in these eagles, usually the female is always larger in size. So there is no other difference between male and female. I mean, unlike other birds, you can distinctly identify male based on its very colorful plumage. But in these eagles, you know, most of the eagles, you cannot differentiate between male and female based on the color or markings of the body. But females are bigger in size. Again, the same Bonelli's eagle. See the beak and the talons, the power in the talons. This is a different eagle, steppe eagle, very powerful. Again, all these eagles are bigger in size and powerful. They kill small mammals small birds, even reptiles. They eat snakes, lizards. This is STSE, the short form, short-toed snake eagle. The toe is short, the toe of the leg, feet. The short-toed snake eagle, it specifically eats snakes. The snake is the main diet for this bird. You see the eyes and the beak. Very beautiful bird. Very, very beautiful bird. This is tawny eagle. Tawny is the color. T-A-W-N-Y. Tawny eagle. Tawny means this color. This, you know, light brown color is tawny color. Again, a winter visitor to our grasslands near Saswad. Now, let's come to the last category, owls. I'll show you only two owls. This is a mottled wood owl. Mottled, M-O-T-T-L-E-D. Mottled is the design. Mottled wood owl. And again, it eats mostly rodents. So, they are our friends. They are farmer's friends. They are friends. And small reptiles. This was taken at night time, this first photo. This is the same owl, but the chick of mottled wood owl. See the color, the mottled design and color. Now, this is the second type of owl, short-eared owl. Eared is E-A-R-E-D. Short. The ear is small. Short. Short-eared owl. Again, this was taken at Karbanwadi. And this is a very common. This is not owl actually. This is very small. This is called owlet. O-W-L-E-T. Owlet. Owl and owlet. Owl is bigger. Owlet is smaller. This is spotted owlet. Because of the spots, you know, small white spots on its body. So this is spotted. And the peculiar feature is its eyes. Very beautiful eyes. Very beautiful. And a beautiful bird too. So that's it. That's what I wanted to show you. The variety of birds which are seen. The last session is some photos of the mammals. So before that, I will just maybe, you know, I have one more small quiz for you all. Two questions. Just try to, let's see if you can answer them. Okay. So, do you know which deer? There are deer, different types of deer we are found, we get in India. So, what is Indian gazelle? And do we see it in and around Pune? Indian gazelle. So the question is, there is a type of antelope. Actually, there is a difference between deer and antelope. We will come back to it later. But Indian gazelle, do we find, do you know if you can see it near Pune? And do you know another name, common name for Indian gazelle?
Not a chital. Yes, chinkara. No. That's right. Sachin Dharani again.
Yes.
Chinkara found near the Saswad area.
Correct. So, chinkara, we will see. I think I have some photos of chinkara. So, Indian gazelle, and it's a Schedule 1 animal, surprisingly. I mean, it has highest protection under Wildlife Protection Act, and it's called chinkara. Chinkara is the English name as well as Marathi name, also called as Indian gazelle. We will see the photos. Okay, so I'll just come out of this slideshow, go to mammals. Okay. Do you know, have you seen this mammal before? I'll just zoom in a bit. This is Indian black buck. In Marathi, it's called Kalvit. Kalvit or Indian black buck. Again, a typical species, a representative species of grassland habitat. And one of the, I mean, main prey species for prey base, for Indian wolf, black buck and chinkara. So this is black buck. again a different photo, a close-up of black buck male. You see the male is black in color and look at its horns, whereas female has the horns are missing or very small in size, and look at the color difference between male and female. So this is black buck male. This is not a mammal, this is a reptile, actually got included in this presentation. This is chameleon. Marathi madhe apan jala rang badalnara sarda, I think Hindi mein usko girgit bolte, I am not sure, but chameleon, Indian chameleon, very beautiful reptile, very very beautiful. Okay, this is the next photo, is chinkara or Indian gazelle. This was taken at a place called Dhauleshwar near Saswad, about 10-15 kilometers from Saswad. Early morning I took it with the rising sun in the background. This was late evening, chinkara only. These are all Silhouette images. Unfortunately, in Silhouettes, the details are not visible. Okay, this is chinkara habitat shot. You see the typical dry, barren land, and on the back, you see different mountain ranges. So this is a typical scrubland habitat represented, and the mammal is chinkara. This is actually Chaushinga. By mistake I included this photo in the presentation. It is not. It is a forest type. Chaushinga or four-horned antelope. The main habitat is jungle. So by mistake I included it. It's not seen in scrubland or grassland. Okay, this is civet, Indian civet. Nocturnal, as you can see, very common. Sometimes we can see it around in our cities also. In fact, I have seen it a couple of times in Kothrud area in Pune. Of course, in the evening, late evening. This is the unfortunate event. I mean, we see it very often nowadays. This is the domestic dog, and it has hunted the hare, Indian hare, Sasa Janamanto, Indian hare. That's a bad thing. And it is bad because if a wolf kills it, it's okay. These domesticated dogs, they can spread rabies, diseases in wild animals, and then it will wipe out whole population of, it may wipe out. That's the research has proven it. Population of wolves or even other wild animals. So that's a bad thing. This is a very cute little pair of Indian foxes. These are the pups of Indian fox. Very cute. Fox is one of the cutest looking animals of Pune. They are sitting near their den. Okay, this is the close-up of a full-grown fox. In Marathi, fox is called as khokad. Khokad. K-H-O-K-A-D. Khokad. Marathi madhe apan tyala khokad mhanto. In English, we call it fox. Jackal. You must have heard about jackal. Indian jackal. Jackal is kolha in Marathi. Kolha. And wolf, Indian grey wolf, is landga. So just remember, fox is khokad. Jackal is kolha, wolf is landga. Wild dog is a different species. It's called ranputri. It's a different species. So people often confuse between kolha, landga, and khokad. They don't know the difference. So this is fox. Same Indian fox in its habitat. You see the grassland habitat. The same, this thing becomes lush green during monsoon. But just a couple of months after monsoon, it becomes dry, barren, yellow habitat. Yellow or brown habitat. This is again, I took it with the GoPro. This is a close-up of the curious fox. Yeah, this is during monsoons. You see the green grassland, and the fox sitting there. A different pose. Look at its tail. Its characteristic feature of the fox is its tail. Besides the innocent, cute-looking face, The tail is a very interesting feature, a big fluffy tail. This is the pup. It was doing, I think, morning yoga. And I was lucky, I was able to capture this pose. It just came out of its den. You can see the den, the ditch is the den. There were four pups. So this one came out first. And as soon as they came up, I mean, it came out, it started stretching. And I could get this pose. This is the Indian hare. This is the main prey species for fox, even wolf, even jackal, hyena. Everyone kills, even our domestic dogs kill them. This is a rare, very common, but very rare to see. Indian hyena. In Marathi, we call it taras. Taras. Taras Marathi madhe manda. And it's Indian hyena or striped hyena. Because of the stripes, black stripes on its body. Very beautiful mammal. Very beautiful mammal. You see, it basically scavenges on dead carcasses of cow, buffalo, goat, you know, dead carcasses lying around, even the poultry waste. So this is the main food for wolf and hyena. But these hyenas sometimes, or most of the times, they kill these stray dogs or domestic dogs. So domestic dogs is their main prey base, which is a good thing actually. Again, a different photo of Indian hyena, striped hyena. This is an unfortunate event. I mean, road kills, they are bound to happen because of the development, because of the growth of human habitation around jungles or, you know, different wild habitats. So this is a dead jackal hit by some vehicle. Unfortunate, but I wanted to show. This is the jackal. You see how different it looks as compared to fox. Fox is smaller in size, cute looking. Whereas this is, I would push double the size of the fox and big healthy animal. This is jungle cat. Sorry, this is jungle cat or wild cat. In Marathi, it's called Ran Manjar. This was taken at Saswad. Leopard. In Marathi, Bibat or Bibtya. Bibat or Bibtya in Marathi. Indian leopard. And very, very beautiful, very, very elusive, shy animal. Numbers, their number is supposed to be more than 8-10,000 in India. But sightings are very, very less because of their shy, elusive nature. And you will ask, how come a leopard is seen in Pune? Yes, we have a leopard. In fact, last year, there were four leopards near Diveghat area. Diveghat is, I think, hardly 20-30 kilometers from Magarpatta, just before Saswad, that area. So, yes, we have leopards in and around. In fact, Sihagad Valley has few leopards. We have photographic records, photographic as well as camera trap records of leopards in Sihagad Valley, which were taken last year. Okay, this was not in, I mean, though this is a leopard, this photo I clicked in Nagzira, but I just included in this presentation. This actually shows how beautiful the leopard looks, and the small design, you know, that design on its body, those circular patches, they are called rosettes. Tiger has stripes, black stripes on its body, whereas leopard has rosettes on its body. So this is the photo of, you see a chinkara. This is not a very good photo, unfortunately, but there are two leopards on the right hand side next to the tree, and on the left hand side there is a chinkara, Indian gazelle. And this photo I took it in the grassland near Parner. So this is the first photographic record, as far as I know, from Pune of grassland leopard. There are many photos of leopards taken in and around jungles, jungles around Pune, I mean Nagzira, Tanoba, Kana, but grassland leopard photo, I think this is the first one. This is again, very commonly seen reptile. This is monitor lizard. In Marathi, we call it ghorpad. Again, very commonly seen. Sorry, these are not mammals, reptiles. But this beautiful looking lizard is fan throated. The throat, you know, it's like a fan. And how, see how colorful that fan is. You know, different shades of blue, red, orange, black, white. Okay, this is a male of the species, and what it does, it is showcasing, it displaying its fan throated, and you know how beautiful throat I have, and it is trying to attract the female. And where was this photo taken? This photo I took on Mahatma Tekdi. Mahatma Tekdi is in Kothrur area. You know, every year, April, May, June, July, you see these lizards. Very common. They are very bold. You can click these photos using your mobile. They are very bold. And a lot of photographers in and around Pune, they go to this hill area every day morning after 8 o'clock because they need sunlight. I mean, they don't come out early from their nest, underground nest. They come out after 8:30 in the morning, and then they start displaying their beautiful fan throat. This is again commonly seen. You must have seen squirrel, three stripes, palm squirrel. This is a piglet, wild pig, a small one of wild pig. Again seen around very commonly. Now coming to the last section of wolves. I'll show you some photographs of Indian wolves. Wolves is a very majestic animal. They usually live in packs or groups, and they hunt as a team. They are very, very intelligent, and unfortunately, very, very endangered. Very few individuals are remaining in the wild. And we are lucky. If you go towards Saswad area, there are many different areas where wolves can be seen. Not very easy, but still, if you can see them in one or two visits, you will definitely see them. If you know the right area, and if you go with the right guide. So this is how a wolf looks. It's a gray-colored Indian gray wolf. This is the young one of Indian gray wolf. And a peculiar feature of any wolf is its tail and its ear. Ear are always, you know, erect, vertically erect. You will never see, you know, like fallen down. The ears are always straight, vertically straight. You see this image also. And the tail is a slim kind of thing. You know, it, unlike fox, fox has a big fluffy tail, whereas wolf has a ashi sadpattal aste ekdam, long elongated. You see, this is the Indian wolf habitat. It can climb mountains, hills, very easily. It is built for stamina. Huge stamina. It can keep on running for hours. Very strong. This is again a young one. A pup. We call it pup. Of wolf. Indian wolf. Look at the ears. This is again a different wolf. This is a female. Subadult female. And it has a chicken. Poultry waste in its mouth. So poultry waste has now become its main food source, unfortunately, because it's easily available. There are so many poultries in and around Pune, especially around Saswat, and all that poultry waste, they just throw it in some barren area. They call it barren area, unused area, which is nothing but our scrubland, grassland, and that's the main habitat of wolves. And this has become one of the primary source of food for wolves. This is how a beautiful, full-grown wolf looks. Very beautiful. Indian grey wolf. This is again different image of a full-grown male. And the habitat, it looks, you know, barren, dry. Because that's the habitat they have adapted to. Here, you see five different wolves chasing away two dogs. Two stray dogs. And a pack of five wolves. This was taken near Mayureshwar Sanctuary, Supe. If anybody wants to know more about Supe, it's a sanctuary anybody can visit. Just type in Google Mayureshwar Sanctuary, Pune, near Pune. And there is some 200-300 rupees entry fee. You can go and visit in your own car. This is again a full grown male wolf. Very beautiful, majestic animal. This horse, of course, it's not a wild horse. We don't have wild horses in India. But you see three different animal species. On the right hand side, you have this common myna, two birds. In the middle, we have Indian grey wolf female. And on the left hand side, the domesticated horse and the typical grassland, scrubland habitat. Sorry, this is the male and the young one of wolf. All these photos taken near Saswad, different areas of Saswad. Again, same wolf, different postures, different moves of wolves. This was late evening one night. There is a female. In the background, you see a setting sun. There is a female here, and there is a small young one, the pup here. I hope you can see the pup on the right hand side in the center. So you see how camouflaged it is. The color, it matches with the terrain. The black on that hill, you know, the yellow and black thing. These animals, they just merge. Even if there are four or five wolves sitting on a particular hill about 100 meters away, you won't be able to spot them unless they move or you watch them through your binoculars. They are so superbly adapted and they are just camouflaged. This is a young one, very small pup, three months old pup, and the female. And usually a female gives birth to 6 to 8 pups. Unfortunately, only half of them survive the first year of their life. So out of the 6-8 pups, the pups are born blind, obviously, and only 2 or 3 survive. And I mean, they survive, become adults. This is a pack of wolves. 5 wolves are seen. I have seen a pack of 11 wolves a couple of times. I could photograph only 9 in one frame. Okay, now this is again a different pack. And you see, I think 7 wolves are visible in this. Actually, it was a pack of 9. There are 2 more wolves around. But in this frame, I could capture only 7. Sorry. Yeah, and this is how beautiful the animal looks. You know, male, female, and sub-adult, and there are other members also in the pack. But this was one of the closest encounter for me, and it was a great moment. I could photograph and record a small video. A female with pups, 2 pups. So that is it. I hope I was able to convey through this small presentation that we have very rich ecosystems or habitats around Pune. We are really lucky. We have so many beautiful birds and mammals in and around Pune. Unfortunately, it is not possible to cover all the mammals and all the birds in a slideshow of 1 hour duration. But that we will try to cover in our film, which most probably will be released in the last week of October. Next month. Wildlife around Pune coming out. So thank you so much. Thank you so much, everyone, for being patient and listening.
Your name is Love.
Sorry.
Thank you, Vigo.
Yeah, and
thank you so much.
Jungle Bales and Magarpatna City for giving me this opportunity to share with you all whatever little knowledge I have about our habitats and wildlife around Pune. Thanks again. If you have any questions, please go ahead.
There is so far only one question. You know, if someone's asking if the great Indian bustard is extinct.
Yes, actually, you know, when I say extinct, there is one female still seen around Nanas area in Pune. This is, I'm talking about Pune.
Pune, okay.
Okay, so as far as Pune is concerned, I think it is extinct because, I mean, Nanas is also considered part of, actually in Solapur, but I say, okay. For time being, let's assume it's part of Pune. But unfortunately, there also, there is only one female, and only one female will definitely die there won't be any offsprings. So it is as good as extinct in Maharashtra. Right.
Okay. They are still found in Rajasthan, however, right?
Yeah. Okay. In fact, there is an area near Nagpur called Varora.
Okay.
There is a small population of great Indian bustards there.
Okay.
So they are not extinct in Maharashtra, but on the verge of extinction. Pune or Solapur, they are extinct.
Okay.
And the only healthy population is remaining in Rajasthan and Gujarat. Gujarat, there is a grassland called Nalia. And in Rajasthan, Desert National Park. Again,
right.
Very beautiful places. If you have liking for wildlife, do try to visit these areas. Desert National Park in Rajasthan near Jaisalmer, and in Gujarat, Nalia grasslands, or near Greater Run of Kutch. All Little Run of Kutch, Greater Run of Kutch, beautiful areas. You can visit.
Thank you so much, Vinod. And I would just like to say that we do arrange, birding trips around Pune. We also have a birding trip coming up to Sattal, Pangot and Manila, which is going to be with Vinod. He is going to be our expert on that trip. And we arrange trips to Dandeli as well. We are planning one to Thattekar as well, which are all birding destinations. Plus, we also have, we arrange forest trips as well, Taroba and Pench and Kanha. So you can follow us on jungle_bells. You will get all the information there, or I have shared our contact information in the chat where you can contact us if you would like to visit these areas. And of course, the we do arrange grassland excursions for half a day or one day or even overnight as per your requirement. Again, where we try to take Vinod whenever he's free. He's a very busy photographer, but we do try to get him, to go with us when possible. So do contact us if you're interested. Someone is saying, please cover fauna too next time, flora. So
yes,
yeah, we will,
Of course, I would love to do that.
Yeah. So maybe we will do a webinar. So Jungle Bells also organizes a webinar once a month. Right now we have this 3 series, which we are doing specially for the Magarpatta group. But we do a webinar once a month about wildlife. We used to do it twice a month during lockdown, but now since people are back to their routines and getting busier, we have started doing one webinar a month. So if you follow us on Insta or Facebook, you will know when the webinars are and you can log in. We do them on Zoom and it's Facebook Live on jungle_bells, which is our page. So you can decide how you want to log in. So thank you once again to Magarpatta Group for taking this initiative for their clients. And thank you, Vinod, so much for taking the time out. And we would like to thank Sanjay Deshpande as well, who is our mentor and supporter in this venture, the Jungle Bells venture. So thank you so much, Sanjay. And thank you to all the people who watched the session today. Sonia is asking one more last question, maybe. Oh, okay, Vinod, you have answered it. I think you've answered only to the host and panelists.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
You can just make it to everyone. But basically, Sonia, he's saying that he has quite a few photos of vultures.
Yes, I have.
Ati, there's a question from Neil also, apparently. Can you share? I mean, he's asking.
Oh, on chat?
Could you share recordings of this session?
Yes. We do send the recording of this session to the Magarpatta group. We upload them again on our YouTube channel as well, which is the YouTube channel is jungle_bells. But we do send the recordings to Magarpatta group, and they, I'm not sure, but I think they will upload it on their YouTube page as well. But you will be able to. You'll be able to see this on Facebook also, because it's been recorded Facebook Live on the Magarpatta group page as well as the Nanded City page, both pages. So it will be live. So you can watch it anytime. You can watch the session anytime on FB.
Right. And if you have any queries related to wildlife destinations, please get in touch with Aarti, Hemangi or me, and we would be very happy to answer your queries.
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you once again. Have a great rest of the Sunday. And we'll look forward to the third session, which is going to be on 26th of September. And that's going to be about forests around central Maharashtra. And Mr. Raghunandan Kulkarni is going to be our speaker. So we look forward to seeing you all then. Thank you so much. Thank you, Vinod. Bye.
Thank you all. Bye. Take care.